Hello everyone, in this video, I will tell you some tips and tricks with the print statement. That's a simple command, but we can do many things. So, first, how to split a string using only the print statement. So here is how to. Just write backslash n like this. You can remember it by n for next. So next line, so it will come in the next line. As you can see, like this. This line has been splitted many times. It's a variable, I am printing the variable also. So you can also use like this way or directly in the print statement. So you can see, after every backslash n, the new line is printed in the next line. So after line, next line, then has been, splitted is coming in the next line, then many times is coming in the next line. Another thing that you would want to do is to tab the letters is some spaces ahead, and to tab we use the backslash t. The t for tab, you can remember it like this. So like here, after 1 we are leaving 4 spaces, that is default for 4 spaces. Then after 2 also there is a backslash t, so space again. Then 3, after 3 also, after 4 also. And after 5, we don't want to print anything, so there is no tab. And if we remove this and run it again, you can see this is coming side to side like 45, but this is 4 and 5, so we will use backslash t again. Another tip is that if you want to write double quotes in the string, and if you try it without any backslash or any command, it will think that the string is ending here. So if I remove this backslash and this one also, so you can see this is an error. You can see here also 14 errors. So if you want to use double quotes in a string, so you can use just simple backslash and another one where it is ending. Now you can see no errors. Another way is to write 3 double quotes in the starting and in the end. So like if you have studied HTML, we use the pre tag. Same here, what we have written will come as it is in the product, predefined you can say. So you can see here, now I'm going to tell you another way to use the same as backslash n. Here we have written the backslash n, so it is coming in the next line like here. We can also use the triple double quotes here also. So like I have done here, you can see this line, it is coming in one line, then has been split over many times using 3 double quotes and just like pre-tag in HTML that I have written for myself. You can also erase that. Then if you want to write a string in one line in the product like this, but it is very long or for some reason you have to use the enter key and move it to next line, you can use the backslash like here. Just a backslash, then next line, backslash again, the next line, backslash again, and so on. But you can see here, in this product, everything is one line, not like this. Like we use 3 quotes here also, so it came in the next line. But we have using 3 quotes here also, but it is coming in the same line because of the backslashes here. Another thing that you would like to do is write a file path like my computer, backslash c, backslash my folder, and so on and so on. And to write a file path, we use backslash. So here, if we use only single backslash, it will think that we are going to use the backslash b command. That means something. So if we have to just type a backslash but not use its property, we can just type 2 backslashes. Like it is showing backslash b here. Now you can see the color will change. So this is all for today. Come back to my next video to learn more about Python, and see you later. Bye.